Hello my dear students, so in this very video I will show you how to use scanner class or scanner class util package instead of util package to write a program. Okay, first of all let's deal with what is package. You might have gone to library many times, right? Since it's very long you might have forgotten, but I suppose library, you do know about library, right? Library is what? Where books are there, right? Different miscellaneous books are there, right? But definitely there are sections, right? There are sections of book. In one section physics books are there, in another section chemistry books are there, in another section mathematics books are there. Will you find drawing book in physics section? Or will you find Hindi books in chemistry section? Definitely not, right? Similarly, there are set of functions and command lines which automatically gets imported as soon as this util library package is imported. Imported means what? To accept, to bring. Understood? Now, all these technical words, this might seem to you very tough, right? Let us understand in a very easy way. Let's suppose your sir or your ma'am asked you to bring Sir Isaac Newton's written physics book. So definitely, as soon as your sir or your ma'am will ask about physics, definitely you will be going to library and onto the physics section, you will search for Sir Isaac Newton's book, right? The title name is Physics Book by Sir Isaac Newton. There might be many physics books, but you are searching about what? You are searching about a physics book written by Sir Isaac Newton. Okay. Similarly, you may assume, similarly there are many functions, many methods, understood, which comes inbuilt with a package. Over here what we have used is util. Understood? See, import java dot util dot, this star mark in computer terminology is known as asterisk, after that semicolon, or you may say terminatory symbol. Okay, after that public class anything. This is the name of the class. You may write anything, right? The class name can be anything except keyword. Keyword is not allowed to be used as class name. Okay, after that curly braces start. After that, public static void main string args. What is this? String args mean passing of string argument. No need of going in detail of all these things. See, from this part to this part, simply you memorize this part. Okay. As it is written, no changes should be there except this thing. Over here you can write anything, but again I am repeating, except keyword should not be present over here. You are not allowed to use keyword. For example, int is a keyword, right? Int is a data type, it is a keyword. You are not supposed to write public class int. Understood? Scanner int is equal to new scanner. This very line tells us that an object is being created. Understood? An object is being created. Now, this new operator, this is also a keyword, new. Remember, new is also a keyword. This new keyword is used to create object. And what is that object? This int. I am going in depth, but it's not required, okay? Simply you memorize all these things. this box. Simply whatever I have written, you memorize this thing as it is. Okay. Now the program starts. Int x comma res. Res result. In short, I have written res. Okay. Int x comma res. These two are what? These two are variables. And what type of variable? Data type is int. That means these two are containers which can contain what type of value? Integer values. Okay. After that, system dot out dot println enter a number. Okay. This very particular program is very important. Why? Because the approach of this program is very crucial. Why? Previously, what I had taught, simply the result was being displayed. But in this case, each and everything will be displayed. In a very arranged way, things will be there. That means what? First of all, something like this will be displayed. Enter a number. After that, since ln is being utilized, cursor will not wait over here. Instead, the cursor will come back over here. Clear? Definitely, as soon as the user will see enter a number, he or she will definitely enter some number, right? Let's suppose the user gave 25. User gave the number 25. That means 25. User hits enter, right? As soon as the user hits enter, this 25 will get inside variable x. Why? Because of this very particular line. Again, check out, parenthesis is present. That means what? This is a function. Okay. This command line, int.nextInt, you are supposed to memorize this line. int.nextInt, I capital. Do not forget, I capital. Okay. int.nextInt. This very line is responsible, whatever the user gives, that very particular number will get inside x, that means the container, only because of this line. Okay. This very command line is very important. It is because of this command line, things get inside container. Right? Okay. After that, res is equal to x asterisk x. What does this asterisk sign tells you? This asterisk sign is responsible for multiplication. In computer terminology, multiplication sign is not present. Okay. Instead, we use this asterisk sign. Okay. Since user gave 25 as an input, result will be how much? Result is equal to 25 into 25. Right. That means square of 25. 625. Right. 625 will be stored inside res. After that, system.out.print res. That means okay, ln was utilized, right? That means enter number is 625. Clear? Result will be displayed as 625. Do remember, as soon as you will give this this symbol, instead of 625, res will be displayed. Okay. Since this double quote, this double quote sign does what? This double quote, whatever the content is present inside this res variable will not be displayed. Instead, this very particular thing will be displayed. Okay. So this is the program. What was the purpose of the program? Write a program to accept a number, display the square of the number. So this was the program. For this very particular question, you are supposed to do this. Okay. So similarly, many of the programs I will show you in my next video.